everyone, and welcome to the first event of this year's ISSF World Cup here at the Olympic Shooting Centre in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil 2016. You've actually joined us just at the right time, and we're about to start with the presentations of the athletes right now. So I'll hand it over to Shank on the shooting range, and we'll introduce to our athletes. Thank you. So 20 years old and looking for her first World Cup medal. So very experienced and only at 26, like Shaq said, the current Olympic champion here. So she's been in three other World Cup finals before, but now looking for her first step onto the podium. So the oldest of the lineup at only 34, but looking to win her first World Cup medal in over 9 years. So making her first appearance in a World Cup final today, huge moment for her. Extremely exciting moment for the 18-year-old, also making her first appearance in a World Cup final today. Number 11 in the world and looking to win her first World Cup gold. Ranked number 3 in the world and looking for that elusive gold medal. So that's our lineup for today. Our jury is David Goodfellow and referee is Alfredo Filio. So a total of 660 athletes and 88 nations represented at this World Cup. But now the focus is on these 8 athletes who finished in the top 8 after qualification and now in with a chance to win one of those World Cup medals. So it's my pleasure to be joined by Ken Parr, the GB rifle shooter. How are you, Ken?
Yeah, very good, thanks. Nice to be here.
Well, thank you so much for joining me. I know I sort of grabbed you at last minute, so you've sort of saved me out of a bit of a sticky spot, so I appreciate that.
No problem at all, happy to help.
So we're only, I think, 4 months away from the Olympic Games. I don't know about you, but it's come around pretty quickly.
Yeah, I mean, 4 years always seem to kind of come around ever quicker each year, and I definitely know that it's a young field today, and they're going to be very excited.
Absolutely,
to get going.
Yeah, 34 years old, it's the eldest, Yusi Ling, I believe. No, Yusi Ling. So everyone else is around 19, 18.
Yeah, making me feel old.
No, not at 27, not at all. So here we are, we're about to start now. The final of the 10-metre air rifle women's event.
For this event, it's a very
So for people that aren't really familiar with the rules of this 10-meter air rifle women's event, it's two series of three shots. That's 150 seconds per series, so 2.5 minutes the athletes get. This is followed by 14 single shots. They get 50 seconds for these, a total of 20 competition shots overall. Eliminations begin after the eighth shot and continue after every two shots until we have our bronze, silver and gold medalists. So this is how the lineup is at the moment. It's very important to get a good start, isn't it?
Yes, I mean, these early shots are pretty crucial. With having the kind of three-shot series, you have a chance to get into your own rhythm a little bit more than the single shots. And obviously, after eight shots, it's first elimination, so the better start you get, the easier it is.
We see it so many times, don't we, where somebody's leading all the way, and then right at the last minute, they just drop down the table. So
you see that a lot, but also if you have a few bad shots at the beginning, it's all over and you're out in eight.
Of course, you need to give yourself your best chance. Yeah, absolutely. Right, so here we are with the first shot. So like I say, they have 150 seconds per series here. Nine point six for Khedmati. Should be looking for to do better later on. Dovering in with 10.7, very good shoot from her. Great to get her eye in that early on.
Yeah, I think there's a little bit of a mixed bag this round. There's quite a variation. So
is it just all important to get yourself settled and just really get yourself in the zone for this, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, it's always quite difficult when you shoot a qualification round and you've got to kind of reset yourself again for the different conditions, and especially in this range where it's you've had the kind of great air conditioning in the qualification hall, where now you're in a big vast arena out.
Yeah, I know you don't know at home, but this is quite hot indeed. I believe it's around 36 degrees outside, and in here there's no air conditioning, so trying to acclimatise yourself to that must be quite difficult.
Yeah, I mean, because you only have about 8 minutes to kind of get yourself set, so obviously the kind of more experienced shooters will be kind of used to kind of making their way from the qualification range to the kind of finals hall, and they'll be kind of used to doing that. I think there's quite a few people that don't have that experience, so it'll be interesting to see how they get on.
And you were saying you find it actually quite cooler because you managed to take off all the clothing.
Yeah,
clothing
I'm
practice.
Sat here in shorts and t-shirt, and
I'm complaining about the heat, but you're comfortable.
Yeah, I think the shooters in their full kit will be a lot more sweaty as this match goes on.
Yeah, exactly that.
Yeah, Daria's had a pretty decent start there, kind of 10.5 average. That's very solid.
Excellent.
That's going to put you definitely in the mix for a gold if you keep that up.
Absolutely. I believe I can see a 10.9 there for Yisu Ling as well, so she can't ask better than that, really, can she?
No. always a Brucey bonus for one of those
course.
Shots.
So how small, for the listeners, how small actually is the target?
So, I mean, the 10 ring's just half a millimetre, so what you want to do is to hit your pellet right smack in the middle of that, each tenth of a point is only kind of a fraction of a millimetre there. I think it's about a quarter of a mil.
So incredible what they're doing, really, isn't it? So the German is in first position. We have Lee Du in second position with 31.8. 0.2 separates the two leads at the moment. Khedmati, not the best start for her. She's down in sixth place. But like we said, everything can change. But we just want to keep themselves up in towards the top of the table.
I mean, that is a great start for the top three. Absolutely fantastic. I mean, I was saying earlier that Daria had a kind of good start with 31.5, but 32.0.
Outstanding, especially with this pressure. You know, we're at the Olympic Stadium. It's just... it's sort of a dress rehearsal for the main event, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, there's certainly going to be a lot of thoughts going on in the heads of these athletes going, I want to be here in a few months' time, and that will certainly play on a few of their minds.
Of course, and this is a chance for them to prove it to their teams and so on and so forth, and hopefully get selected for the Olympic Games.
Yeah, it's certainly going to be tough picking the Chinese team, for sure.
I was going to say, that's quite a pool of athletes, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, you've got three in the final today, and of course only two will be able to make it come the Olympics, so obviously they want to prove it to themselves.
So you don't want to be in the position of the coach when it comes down to the choosing there.
Well, I mean, the coach has got a great choice.
Oh yeah, true.
It's the athletes.
Yeah. Someone's going to be disappointed. Yeah.
So, yeah, I think we've got Nina Koritsa shooting well again with 10.6 and Dario with 10.7. So they're continuing
really in the zone
on
here, aren't they?
Yeah.
It really surprises me. I wasn't sure how it's going to be. Like I say, with the pressure and everything, I didn't know how they're going to get on, but they really are enjoying this range.
Yeah, I guess it doesn't feel so cramped in this range because it's such a kind of big venue that you can probably have a little bit more of your own space and
sort of disappear into your own space. Yeah. No, it's absolutely vast. I think it's the largest finals hall I've been in, actually. Yeah. They put a temporary stand behind us here in the commentary table, but a temporary stand, but behind that is some concrete seating a little bit further away from that, so it's very vast indeed.
And it's going to be quite an atmosphere come the Olympics in here, I'm sure. Once this gets packed out full of people.
And once the crowd get into it, once everything starts rolling, yeah, absolutely. So how have you found the facilities? You enjoyed everything?
Yeah, it's been really good. It's been my first day on the range today, and kind of got a bit of training on the 50-meter range, and it's absolutely lovely. And barely a patch of wind, and yeah, I'm sure it's going to be some high scores.
Nice. Certainly warm, isn't it?
Yeah, lovely, lovely facility. 10-9 there in the mix.
Absolutely outstanding at this stage of the game. So each athlete will have their own sort of technique, handling of the rifle, their own sort of techniques, would they prefer? And
yeah, and 2 10-9s to finish on that one from Darren and Dooley. So, I think Dooley shoots a little bit slower than the rest of the field, but obviously she's quite experienced, so she knows what she's doing.
Of course, she knows exactly what she's doing, yes. Yeah, quite a nice crowd here, everyone for the support. So Bedovina is in first position, incredible really, for 63.6. So this is the two series, we've just shot the two series now, and we will go into the single shot series now. So two more shots and then we'll decide eighth place.
Yeah, not sure what the gap is. I think it's less than a point there for eighth place, so there's still plenty to play for in the last two shots. Yeah, so the viewers at home won't be able to see 7 and 8th place.
I was going to say, I thought I was missing something. I thought I was back in shotgun and only 6 athletes.
Yeah, maybe some teaming difficulties there with things, but no. Chinese Zhang is in 8th place at the moment, 0.8 behind the Mexican. And that's only a kind of 0.1 gap to kind of 6th, so it's still pretty open at the moment.
Absolutely. There's the Russian, the leader at the moment.
Yeah, quite an old-looking rifle there. Not too many people shooting wooden stocks these days, but the people that do use them are very happy with them.
Is it one of those things that you just wouldn't want to change? You're so used to that rifle and trying to update that?
I think a lot of people think there's a lot better feeling shooting with wood as opposed to kind of aluminium.
Yeah.
But you don't quite have that adjustment. But if you can kind of get settled with a wooden sock, then by all means carry on shooting.
That rifle's definitely been loved in its day, hasn't it?
Yeah.
So we are in danger at the moment. In eighth place is Chinese at Zhang. She's 0.4 off safety. Seventh place at the moment, the German. Russian. Governor still in first position, and 0.5 behind her is the German.
Yeah, I mean, she's closed that gap though with Zhang, so she was 0.8 behind, now it's down to 0.4. So if she puts another good shot in, then she's got every chance of staying in.
Absolutely, still go either way. People at home, you won't be able to see 7th and 8th place, so we do apologise about that. We're trying to sort that at the moment. But after this shot, one athlete will be eliminated in 8th place. So we talked before we came on air actually about the music. You can hear that in the background now. Are you one of these athletes that enjoys that, or would you prefer?
I think it kind of adds to the atmosphere a bit. I think we've been probably too stale across the years by insisting on silence. I think having a bit of music and kind of a bit of crowd participation is definitely what the sport needs, and kind of build that pressure, because you want to make it a pressure cooker for the athletes at the end of the day.
Absolutely, and want to make it exciting as possible.
Zhang's already kind of already putting her stuff away, thinks she knows she's out already.
Yeah, unfortunately, I think so. Yeah, it's definitely confirmed. 8th place for Zhang. Not what she would have hoped for, but. Oh no, absolutely. Sorry, forgive us, it's just changed on the scoreboard here. It is the German. It's Kreutzer that leaves us today in 8th place.
Zhang's got to put her gun back on the sand and get ready for the next shot.
I was
going
to say preempting, slightly premature there.
I think it's always crucial of just keeping in your zone until you're actually ready and you hear your name get called out.
Absolutely, you still go either way. As badly as you feel, somebody else can be feeling the same way.
Yeah.
Here we are, we can see it now. 8th place, Zangrupin is 7th. Yisiling, her teammate, in 6th, and their other teammates in 3rd position. Domina's still in 1st position, though. Incredible shooting. I think she's led from the beginning, actually.
She was just 3rd off her first 3 shots, but she's climbed all the way up, and she's kind of getting a nice lead going there. It'll be interesting to see how the Chinese girl Zhang kind of gets on.
If she recovers from putting the rifle away.
Yeah, it might actually be a bit of an advantage that she forgets about the final and the scores going on and actually just worries about her shooting for the next couple of shots.
Do you find yourself looking at other people's scores, or do you concentrate on?
I mean, it's difficult not to when you've got that screen in front of you, but the idea is try and avoid it as much as possible, because you obviously can't control what your opponents are shooting. You can only control yourself. So if you put in a couple of 10.9s for a few shots, you always know that you're going to give yourself
Absolutely.
A chance.
I'm sure you get that confidence and that buzz anyway. Domina still in 1st position. In danger at the moment is Zhang Binbin in 7th place, so the next shot will decide that.
Yeah, I think 1.3 gap now for Zhang is going to be hard to close there.
Yeah, it's a little bit hard to come back from. Yeah.
I wouldn't say it was impossible, because you never know what happens, but I think that's a pretty big gap to bridge.
As a shooter, this must be a wonderful opportunity to be on the range that hopefully you'll be on for the Olympics, and hopefully they find out for those gold medals.
Yeah, I mean, part of it is real big kind of preparation to it, and kind of get yourself in the zone. What's it going to be like in 4 months? And I think definitely the qualification rounds, there'll be a lot of people that be like imagining that kind of for the next 4 months when they're in training, and the finals hall. I think there'll be a few more kind of Olympic decorations put up for the game. So it'd be kind of.
Yeah, I've heard there's going to be a few more screens, a few more, like you say, I think it's going to be floored again and things like that, but they're just in those final preparations here now.
Yeah, so I'm sure this will look absolutely fantastic come the game. And, the athletes are having a nice surprise.
That's it, 7th place. Zhang Binbin takes 7th place, unfortunately. Let's say she couldn't really recover from that 1.3 gap, could she?
No, I think it was always going to be a struggle for me. Some few earlier shots went away. And I think now that we've got Zhang in 7th, we've got a really tight final on our hands, really. It's a half a point gap between 6th and bronze. Absolutely nothing, as we would know.
Any of them could get on the podium today.
Yeah, I think Gishwanda's just taken the lead after a 9.7 from Dara. And it'll be interesting to see if she recovers from that 9 or starts there.
Just gets it out of her mind and just carries on. Yeah, apparently this range is based completely on the Sydney Olympic range. They've literally taken it and put it here.
Yeah, I mean, it's a good idea, because it's absolutely lovely range out in Sydney as well. So
I think they saw what they wanted and then just brought it here. Yeah, it's not a bad idea.
Yeah, indeed. I've unfortunately only shot in Sydney once, but it was.
That's more than me. So. .10.6 from Dovina there. So.
Yeah, I think a few good shots were in the mix there. Yeah. And Stranda 10.2 was slightly less than she would have wanted after having actually 9.9. So after getting into the lead, she's a drop off.
Maybe a little bit too much confidence.
From Zumaya, Flores there, it's definitely put herself back in the mix for even kind of silver probably at this stage.
Next,
She's in some trouble here. And 9.6 on the last shot, so 10.5 definitely gives her a chance to
kind of stay in. Yeah, she doesn't look the happiest. Yeah.
No, I think that 9.6 is still worth in the head, really.
Playing in their mind, yeah. It must be so hard just to get that out and just concentrate on what you have to do.
I mean, it's always challenging with these knockout finals. It is, if you have that bad shot, you always know that you're in that risk of going out, and that puts a little bit more pressure on. Whereas in the qualification round, you have so many more shots to kind of recover from it.
So these athletes, how long would they have taken in qualification today and then come to this? So it's quite a long day for them, isn't it? Especially in there.
Yeah, especially coming from the hotel. I think quite a few people probably would have been up at 5 o'clock this morning, and it's just after midnight.
Yeah, it's a long hour, like 2 hour drive, isn't it? So UC Ling there, just being eliminated, unfortunately. Great shooting by all the athletes. Well, I don't know what's happening there.
I think she might have just got a yellow card from not opening loading before she should have done.
So hopefully that won't play on her mind either.
But she managed to stay in on that one, so another couple of shots she's got chances. She was very much on the precipice there for not making it through. Just got the camera on here, Daria, and I think she's been having a good match so far. So
that old gun's working perfectly.
It is working very well for her, and she looks very relaxed doing it. I don't think there's been kind of too much emotion there on her face. So 9.9 there. Commentator's curse, as for usual.
of course. But yeah, so she hasn't won a World Cup medal either, Domina. So it's an incredible shooting from her, you know.
Actually, there's been a few low shots in this round, and really as the kind of pressure starts to build as we're building up to the
exactly,
the
they all can see that podium, can't they, now? They all can sort of smell it coming.
Yeah, Du Lee takes the lead after being kind of out of it, really, for the first 10 shots.
Yeah, absolutely. She's really proved herself here.
That bit of experience telling in the final stages. So she's escaped one set of eliminations. Can she pull herself out again?
Absolutely, we'll soon find out.
10.0, that might not be enough.
Could go either way, isn't it?
Sam to rely on a weaker shot from her opponents here.
10.5 by Dovina. Like a bad square round, actually a 10.6 from Zumaya as well. Yep, so that's it, she goes out in fifth position. Great shooting from her though.
Yeah. Yeah, no, she's still a very kind of young athlete there, so kind of she's got a lot of time on her hands to kind of make the most of her.
Because she won her first World Cup medal, she won a bronze in Gabala earlier this year as well, so she's obviously becoming, really getting into her.
Yeah, and I think she'll be trying to build towards the Olympics and probably just trying to secure a slot, because I know there's a lot of talent on the Iranian team. I think this is where it kind of really gets to the serious point, because no one wants to be fourth.
No, yeah. Sure, that's the worst position. Okay.
Yeah.
So do you feel like you've been cheated a little bit? You must feel slightly, you know, maybe take sixth, fifth, but fourth, you've been so close.
I remember being fourth before, and in some other competitions, and that hurts when you're that close to another.
I can imagine.
I think the crowd is trying to get a little bit more involved for this one. Their interest is perked up now that the medals are to be decided. So Zumaya from Mexico, she's shot 9.7, so that's going to hurt. I think she was kind of in the frame there for a medal. And I think think that commentary of being told you're the only shooter to shoot nine is definitely going to play on your mind there.
Absolutely, you can't help but hear that. No. Yeah, how do you feel about it? Obviously, I used to do the announcing and now I've gone into this TV commentary, but how do you feel? I always feel bad, especially with English-speaking athletes. Yeah. I always feel so bad when we have to do a negative comment. How do you feel about it? Do you zone out?
You try to, but I don't think you need to be told when you've shot a nine, so... I think that rubs it in just a little bit, but I think the idea is just to recover from that, and I think she looks still pretty focused in her face.
Absolutely, so, I was going to say, just trying to keep that heart rate down, just trying to keep it. So we are, this shot decides fourth place. Unfortunately, the one who misses out on the podium today.
Another nine.
There are the last athlete just shot, and it's Zumaya Flores who exits in fourth position.
I mean, she's done very well today. First World Cup final. And
amazing opportunity. You can't really pick a bigger stage except for the Olympics. You know, it's just amazing for her, amazing for her team. You know, she's had great support by her colleagues there as well.
Yeah, she's still got a smile on her face.
Exactly, so. She seems happy. Yeah. So here we are, we have our three medalists, but it's time to decide which athlete receives which coloured medal today. Lee Du is currently in first position, Dovana is in second position, and Schwantner is currently in bronze place at the moment. But like we said earlier, everything can change in just these two shots.
Yeah, I mean, there's 1 point between first and third, so this is very much up for grabs, especially when it comes to a little bit more of the serious part, when the medals and the nerves are really starting to kick in.
So yeah, Lee Du hasn't had a World Cup medal actually for 9 years.
Yeah, it's quite a long time. She hasn't kind of been to as many World Cups as she had been before, and but obviously
she's got an amazing CV. Yeah. You know,
Olympic champion in Athens.
Olympic champion in Athens. Yeah, four times World Cup finalist, gold medalist, and 5 times World Cup gold medalist. So, you know, very experienced indeed. So it'll be great for her. It'll be great confidence for her to get this day.
Yeah, and also shoots very well in three position then as well. So kind of vast experience across all events.
That's it, 10.9 for the German.
Exactly the time you want it, isn't it?
Exactly. Couldn't have planned that much better.
Yeah, 0.1 between Dario. I mean, for someone who's been kind of leading quite a lot of the way, I mean, that's...
I know, it's got to be a slight disappointment, hasn't it? But great shooter from the German there. Yeah. So only 0.5 separates her from that top spot. And this shot will decide who takes home that bronze medal today. It's all important for her to get a great shot here. Two 10.2s.
Yeah, you can hear the crowd. It just starting to build a little bit more in here.
Taking their time.
10.2. Oh. I think she might have just got bronze there.
That's it, she has. The German after the 10.9 in bronze position. That's how quickly this can change. Yeah. I mean, it just to and fro, doesn't it? Absolutely.
Yeah, indeed. And definitely think there's a bit of excitement there. And but picks up a bronze medal, which is, I'm sure,
so
she's
you can't really complain,
happy.
Can you? Yeah, absolutely. So a bit of a disappointing finish for her, but she's going to be happy there. Bronze medal, yeah, hugging the coach there, really happy.
Yeah, I think that was her first medal at World Cup. First medal in the World Cup, so nice place to start. So now we've got really interesting last two shots to point forward the gap.
This is it. The Russian against the Chinese athlete. So it's basically we have two shots now to decide which athlete receives that gold medal today.
And it's great that they're actually next to each other as well.
Absolutely. Do you prefer that? You'd prefer to be close and sort of putting the pressure on a little bit?
Yeah, I mean, because you'd definitely be able to hear any other person shot, especially Dooley, she shoots a little bit slower. So yeah, she would definitely be the last to kind of shoot her shot on this one. 10.3 there from Dara Davina, which is, keeps it in the mix. Oh, like for like.
That's it. Everything stays the same. As we go into the final shot of the 10-meter air rifle winners event, the first event of this World Cup in Rio. It's been quite a final, though, hasn't it?
Yeah, it's been a really good final, really high standard. A few shots in there that kind of let some others down, but that's kind of kept interesting.
I mean, extremely high, 10.8, 10.9s all over the, you know, all over the board. So it's been really great. Here we are, the final shot. Who takes home the gold today? Showing their support here.
10.3 there, so as long as it's a kind of 10, then Julie's got this one won. Another 10.3.
Another 10.3, so there it is.
Yeah. So she knows she's won there.
Absolutely, can't help but hide the happiness there. So the gold medalist, Julie of the People's Republic of China. Very happy there. Ken, I've got to thank you so much for joining me today. I really appreciate it.
Not at all. It's been a pleasure.
Always nice to have a nice guest for the first event and get us off to a good start. So it's been an absolute pleasure. And silver medalist goes to the Russian Federation's Daria Zdovina. Incredible shoot from her. Like I say, leading nearly all the way, but just unfortunately dropping out in second position. But still, they're both going to be happy with that. There they are, there's the three athletes, the three medalists. So thank you so much for joining us here today at the Rio Olympic Centre 2016. And we will see you next time. Thank you.
Republic of China, what is it?